I think what I'm really passionate about is how do we better communicate this amazing world of architecture that we're so deep into to the public? And here's what it means to be good architecture. And also, here's how we can make the world better. Here's a better way of doing those things.
So one of the cool things, you know, in this idea about trying to implement something early is this whole new platform or paradigm shift is Autodesk Forma.
I do get excited by Forma. I haven't like played around with it a ton, but this is sort of SketchUp-ish that you can play around that has a lot more robust sort of tools to it, and then it transitions to Revit. And I know you've like done a bunch of videos and training on that. Like,
yeah. Autodesk Forma is amazing. It's probably one of the most used new tools at Lake Flato. We're doing it on so many projects. And the tool itself is really quite transformative in a lot of ways. Doing anything early on, right? Everybody says it, almost nobody does it. Let's do an energy model.
Right.
Let's do wind analysis and things like that, and embodied carbon analysis, like while the project's still adjustable. Make
right.
changes early enough in the design to make them meaningful. Climate Studio actually wrote a blog post, it's Salima, the company, about a project, a middle school we were designing in New Mexico. And the whole point of the blog post, of course, part of it was that we used their tool to do daylighting, but the fact that our design performance team at Lake Flato worked with the design team in the office so early in the project that you could see in the iterations the design actually changing. Like
right.
we had a gymnasium that we were able to get to 100% spatial daylight autonomy. We ended up adding a perforated panel over part of the exterior windows. We added a skylight and then moved the skylight around. And you can do these different massing options. And the massing can be done in Forma. Autodesk even made an add-in to Rhino that is a connector. It's not quite a live connector, but there's a push-pull button. Mm. So you hit pull and it pulls in the contextual geometry. You can make some really cool stuff and then push it into Forma. So with these different options of geometry, you can do wind analysis. And while you're pushing things around, if you're doing the massing in Forma, Forma's using AI to do wind analysis, so the heat maps of the wind.
Right.
And then you can do the full 60 to 90 minute computational fluid dynamics level wind analysis. And we've actually compared that to Eddy 3D, which is a Grasshopper plugin for Rhino.
Mm-hmm.
And they're really close. Another thing that we've been doing a lot lately, which is really cool in our urban planning and mixed use projects, is traffic noise analysis.
Mm.
So you basically take the speed limit of a road. Sometimes that comes in when you create a contextual model in Forma, and then also the average daily traffic numbers. So how many cars are on the road in the day. And then you can also break it up by time of day, that 2,100 cars are on this road out here on the street. And most of those are between like 9 a.m. and 4 p.m. And it actually projects a heat map in decibels onto the surface and the face of the building of the noise from cars and railroad tracks.
Like, I don't want to say like, hey, everybody, just use Revit. You know, it's like, okay, there's some inefficiencies, but like design is inefficient in a lot of ways, right? To me, and where I'm starting to dive into Forma and want to do it more is of, you know, thinking about passive strategies, right? Where I've been, you know, trained in that early on and trying to think about orientation of a building, sizes and openings, shading, et cetera.
Mm-hmm.
I have a friend, he's a MEP engineer and an licensed architect. And so I try to bring him in on every project, and
cool.
he's running energy models and things. I like give him the model, comes back a week later and he gives me numbers, and I'm like, okay, well, let's kind of tweak this. But having that real time thing, right, is really powerful.